This is DJ Adam01time coming to you from the one and only Tangle Grid. That's right. And we've got a great show for you. Got a featuring, that's right, Virtual Highway. They are some of my best friends. Great people over there. And you know what? One of my favorite designers I've known for years. And so, you know, we're going to go over there and visit and take a look at their winter stuff also. And, you know, after that, we're going to head on over to a land called Ignis. That's right. Ignis, Gwelth. And Ignis is a region, and Gwelth is like an island in the middle of it. And it's really cool. I wanted to get into Metropolis, but they were down for some maintenance or something. So we're not going to have the random there, so I just kind of did a random pick from this Ignis Gwelth. It's a beautiful, beautiful island build. And then we're going to take time to look at some of the third-party viewers. And what exactly when they say, you know, you have to be running Windows 7 or Windows 8, whatever, 64-bit system. And is it truly a 64-bit viewer? Because there's only a few out there that are actually truly 64-bit viewers. So I get this question all the time. What is truly a 64-bit viewer? So we're actually going to go through that and actually look at the source code and let you understand exactly what a 64-bit viewer is and how it's actually compiled up that way. And then from then on, we're going to have, of course, the one and only, that's right, the G-Spot, the Google Plus shout-out. We're going to get over there and take a look at that. And then we have some real-life stuff. Eric Garner, He was a poor man that was choked to death by the police, and the grand jury did not indict the officer. And, you know, I wasn't there. I did see the video. I did hear the man begging. He couldn't breathe. But, hey, that's our show for today, so let's get started. Virtual Worlds and Virtual Highway. Here we go. Virtual Highway, we're having a blast coming in here today. Oh, founders Tiffany and Lager, you guys have done a great job. Wonderful couple who have put this thing together for everybody to come in here. They work very hard every day on hand. So let's take a time and look around here because this is their welcome center. They have done a great job, and I do know that this place is totally handled by the people that live here and are part of it. So coming in here and being part of it and owning a sim also means you can be part of the team. The Virtual Highway team are wonderful people, and I don't know what to say. I call them down-home folks, you know. They're always treating me with just such respect. It's fantastic. Their learning center is a really neat place. It's a wonderful walk, so if you need to practice your walk or something, it's a gorgeous walk walking down here. And just look at the fine textures and everything. Coming through there, I asked them, I said, hey, there's no texture on that one. That's not supposed to be. It's the building block. So we're teaching people how to build. And you get down here. Not only that, they have a wonderful place down here that's got scripts and all kinds of stuff, sculpties and everything to get you going, help you get built, you know. And when you get on in here, they've got some wonderful tutorials back in here. And I come in here and hang out with these people, and I just loved them. They started out in Second Life. They went over to other virtual worlds, and they're active. You come in there and get a hold of Megan Klein or Tiffany or Lager, and you know what? They're hands-on people. They will help you right out. They will take time. They'll even go into Skype. They'll do anything for you. They're just fantastic folks. And that's the way it should be in Virtual Highway. So get out there on the highway, and we're gonna look at some more places around here. So DJ Adam, let's go take a look around. One of my favorite peoples is MC Designs. Just wonderful people. And coming in here and seeing this place is just phenomenal. It's huge. And so I asked her, I says, Megan, where's your main store at? She goes, It's the whole sim. This whole place is my creations and my stores. And I says, it's just amazing. She goes, oh, yeah. She says, and not only that, I helped work on the North Pole, helped build the North Pole. So if you get a chance, stop over at the North Pole. And so, hey, we're taking a good look around here, and it's just something else. And she says, well, you know, I have a really good friend of mine who does all the work with me, and that's Susie Sack. And I said, oh, wow, really? Well, let me come on in and yak with you also. So here we are here together in front of MC Design's whole sim. Wonderful people. And Susie Sack is there on my left, which would be your right. And, of course, Megan Klein, turn around and, oh, I was spinning around. Now they're on my right and left. And these are some of the hardest working avatars on this grid. It's something else. These two have done a lot. These are their stuff from furniture to sculpts to mesh to you name it, scripts. And, of course, you know, hey, TJ Adam, can you make me some animations? Well, you know, I'll see if I can't fire up the old animation maker and see what's going on. But this is just a wonderful place to come visit. This is Megan Klein Designs. Hey, get a chance now. We're going to get ready to pop on over to North Pole. Well, landing over here at the North Pole, man. Whew, I popped in here. And just take a look around at this beautiful build. It's going on. All these rides are interactive, and they do work. It's just wonderful. Hey, you know what? I'm telling you, Santa Claus has got it made this year in the virtual world. He's just flying into all this cool weather. And Rudolph, you don't have to burn it off. It's amazing when you come in here, the amount of detail and work that goes into these beautiful builds. And again, Megan, Tiffany, Lager, and Susie, you guys have done a great job. Wow, look at that. They have a complete stadium and dancing and everything up in the air here. Isn't this gorgeous? Just beautiful. Yeah, let's have a party. Get on up here and boogie out with Miss Santa Claus. Man, I need a Miss Santa Claus real bad. Dropping back down into town here. It's just gorgeous. See all the snow top roofs and everything. And it just amazes me, you know. And come down here in the welcome area. It tells you everything and all the stuff going on. And it's been a blast. I enjoy coming in here and doing this. And you guys, I'm so proud of Virtual Highway. They've always been great to me and always will be. And maybe I can talk them into having an interview with the founders. Hey, you never know. We'll check it out. Maybe it'll happen. Hey, well, that was really nice. The North Pole and all that, that's a blast over there, Virtual Highway. Hey, now we're going to head on over here to Ignis, man, and check out this island of Gwelth. And in the land of Ignis, dwells the land of Gwelth. And we land here today, and it's just a wonderful place, popping in here and looking at this gorgeous land and building in the middle of the ocean out here. And we gather about and look at the structures, and we just marvel at how beautiful this place is.
When the air beats tight retreat along the rocky shoreline, leaves the trail of tidal cruise in a short-lived galaxy. Each microcosmic planet, a complete society. A simple time mirror to reflect upon our own, all the busy little creatures chasing out the destinies. Living in the pools, they soon forget about the sea.
DJ Adam01time. Beautiful build. Hop in and take a look at it. And here's the places you got to choose from. Yeah, click one and go there. I did. It's been a blast. All right, this segment here, we're going to take a look at the third-party viewers we've picked out today and exactly what does it mean by 64-bit. Well, today we look at the third-party viewers, and are they really 64-bit for Windows or not? That is the question. Are they really? So we see here that it, he recommends that you use a Windows 64-bit system. But is it really built was for 64-bit libraries? Hey, you go over here and we look at his stuff. You see he's got a Windows build but not a Linux build. And we go in and we actually look at his auto build where he actually pulls the pre-builts. And you'll note that all of the pre-builts come from Linden Labs. So those are all 32 bits, probably except for his private FMOD X, whatever. So we're looking over here at Firestorm, and we go in there, and you'll note Firestorm, it looks like they only have 64 for Linux and no 32-bit for Windows. Well, that's really not true. Actually, Firestorm uses a different build system, and they've got what they call an override for Windows, INI. And what that does is when you run auto build script, it tells it if you're going to build the 64-bit Windows, it will then use these pre-builts instead. So you actually truly do get a full 64-bit build. These are built Windows 64-bit pre-builts. And so that is a true 64-bit build. Now you come on into Singularity. Singularity uses the older type. They have this older type install XML like from the Snow Globe times. But hey, guess what? It's still all V3. And you look down. Singularity has everything. 64-bit Windows, 64-bit Linux. And it's a big deal. You know, I'm not sure if you're going to see Mac going over... They do have some 64-bit Mac builds, but we'll see what's going on with that in the future. Cocoa, the beginning, it all started there. Hey, hey, Nikki Peran over there. I'm telling you what, you guys done it. You guys found it, started it, and wanted the first Linux builds in 64-bit. You know, all the team over there, whether it's from McCabe to Barundas, you know, it's where it all began. The 64-bit builds are absolute stable, wonderful stable builds. The Cocoa team has been way above it. Team Purple has stayed with whatever they can do to keep that up going too. It's great, either Cocoa or Imprudence. And they do use, the only thing is they are not a true 64-bit for Windows. They're still using 32-bit that I see from here. And maybe that may change down the road, but they have a 64-bit build for Linux and compatible, you know, for Windows. So that's been our third party for today. Cocoa, you guys started it out, and everybody else has really been on the ball with it, too. So... DJ Adam 01 time. Well, that's that time again where we take a look at our G-Spot. Google Plus. Let's go take a look at our Google Plus today and see what's going on. Going on here, Stephanie Meiser. Boy, you got up there early this morning there. Thursday, Frida's Winter Place, tea and talk for writers. And Winter Open Mic. Hey, how about that there? Selby Evans. Hey, buddy over at Kylie, man. He wants that... setting up a project for getting you paid through PayPal with a tip jar. Hey, that's a great idea, man. That's good to work on that. Joyce Donahue, hazards of putting up the tree. Look at the cat in the tree. Oh, my gosh. I had a dog one time decide to eat my tree. Yeah. I took him to the vet, too. He got some stuff stuck in his mouth. Layton's got some really good open education, Europia, and everything else. Oh, don't forget my rush circumstances. Go look up those lyrics. They're awesome. More Stephanie's got some more stuff to talk about. Hey, the never-ending winner in Second Life. Hey, you got to check it out. Hey, getting on down here, Brandon Casey. We're talking about some really good Rush stuff and some great coffee. Layton, you got even more stuff. Good morning, Googler is Open Simmers. Quickly, early morning question. What is the best viewer for Open Sim and the Mac? Not the Fleetwood Mac. Hey, I would probably go with probably most likely be the Firestorm viewer. And there we go. We got Melina Horton over there at Highlights of Virtual Highways. This is Summer Head. DJ Tanks at the back door starts there at today at 3 p.m. to 5 p.m. We got DJ Lager at the Enclave Dance Club. Yeah. Yeah, those are the things going on over there. And what you're about to see here is murder. Plain and simple. A man pleading for his life. And then after you watch this, I'll explain to you the truth of how the taxpayer is being ripped off for this.
Touch me. Damn.
You have a man says he's selling illegal cigarettes, untaxed cigarettes. One, that's really not what the bust is all about. One, the real bust is about the fact is that if a cop busts a man selling non-tax cigarettes, that becomes a federal. They turn that over to the feds, the alcohol, ATF. What that means is the moment they go and put him into a county jail, they can start charging the feds their $96 a day or $114 a day. They know that this man is not going to have enough. He's going to do a plea bargain, going to get 5 or 6 years. So now he's going to generate revenue for that county from the feds, your taxpayers' dollars. And then he's going to end up in the feds for at least a mandatory 5 years, which our private prison system is going to take the money from you again. So if you all think you rich people are being safe, you're just actually being ripped off by the rest, by what's going on as they line the pockets of your county jails. There is a simple fact. It's all it is to it. Why else would you mess with a guy who's 450 pounds? You know he's not going to run from you. If he falls down, he's not going to get up fast. This is plain, flat-out murder for money. That's it. Simple as can be. DJ Adam, 01time, we're out of here. Upon our own, all the busy little creatures chasing out the destinies. Living in the pools, they soon forget about the